Greetings everyone and welcome to GameQuest First Look. Today I am looking at Logistics and Warehouse Simulator. It's a very weird title. It's just come out on Steam today and I thought I'd take a quick look to show you what it's like in case you're thinking of buying it. So, what we've got from the menu here, it looks to me as if we're going to be setting up a shop or something. I don't quite know. I think you can only drive a forklift truck. Now, I do actually have Forklift Truck Simulator. It's quite an old title, and I've played it before quite a few years ago, and it'd be interesting to see how far the forklift truck gaming has evolved. Oh, God, makes me sound like I'm interested in it or something. Right, let's just go and start game. Okay, so standard game, level 1 department store. In fact, we can't do anything else. It's all locked, so we're going to have to do the department store, the wholesale department store. Forklift type is the electric pallet truck. Okay, let's start. Okay, here we go. Standard game, task 1. There are in aisle 5A pallets that are ready for an order. Is that English? There are in aisle 5A pallets I understand it. Within the specified time, bring the respective pallets to the locations in the parking lot. Try not to damage the goods while driving. Otherwise, you will lose points. Good luck. Okay, right, here we go. And we're driving it. And, oh my God, here we go. Right, so we're going to go over. It's got one of those rear wheel steering things. It's going to handle a bit strangely. Right, here we go. Let's try not to run this woman over. Oh God, I cannot control this at all. Let's definitely not try to run her over. That's definitely not something we want to do. Right? Right? No. Oh, come on. Oh, okay. Okay, game. But it does mean that we don't have to worry about avoiding them. Just go through this guy. Just go through this guy. Okay, right. Where are we going? We're going to 5A. Here we go. Just over here. Let's move this around. Rear wheel steering. So we have to kind of get used to this. Actually, that's pretty cool. That's pretty easy to handle, to be honest. Right, here we go. So now what do we do? We've picked it up. It doesn't tell me what I have to do here. What am I doing? Why don't you just tell me what to do? Oh, okay, here we go. Select camera, move stacker, move forklift. Page up and down, tilt fork backwards. There we go. Right, okay, let's just go back to that view. Right, okay, so how do we get out? I'm guessing it's that little break in the wall straight ahead where that sunlight's coming through. Right, here we go. So that's how it works. And page up and page down tilts it. I guess this one doesn't tilt because it's just a pallet thing. Right, here we go. Through the shop, through this. What's it? Is this like Costco? I've never actually been to Costco, but I imagine this is what Costco is like. Out through here. Excuse me. Beep, beep. Is there a horn button? There's not a horn button. Okay. But there is space bar for brake if we need it. Okay, here we go. And we're going out. Ooh, to squeeze past. This is quite a nice looking. Quite a nice looking shop here. Where are we? What sort of country we're in? Okay, let's have a look. We're in Germany, if we're going by that car there. That's a German car, German plates. Right, and so I guess we're all just in Germany. It's where most things are based, isn't it? Apart from, no, I see, it's a German imported American car. It's okay, we're in Germany. Nothing's out of the ordinary here. Oh, look! It's the New York taxi cab from New York Taxi Simulator. It's back again, and it's got one of those, how many studs is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's got an 8-stud wheel from a truck. Oh, of course, they've all got 8-stud wheels from trucks. Of course, there had to be that in it. That's the UIG way. In fact, isn't that the same game? I think that is the same publisher, UIG. Right, anyway, let's just put that down. And that will be mission complete. Right? That's it all done, isn't it? Wait, there's more? Oh, come on, there's more? Can I go through the cars? Hang on, I want to see if I can crash into cars here. Here we go. Oh, we kind of can. The pallet thing doesn't really... Let's go out that view. The pallet thing doesn't really react with anything, but at least the main part of the forklift does. Right, here we go. Let's put that back into normal view, because apparently we are a ghost! Oh God, no one's controlling it. No one's paying any attention to the fact this thing with a mind of its own is just kind of traveling through, about to hit him. Nope, nothing. Nothing. Oh, look, it even opens up when you get close to it. Isn't that wonderful? Let's take a look around. So this is the store. It's all very... It's like IKEA. When you get to the end of IKEA, when you kind of get those stacks with all... You know what I mean. You know what I mean. If you've ever been to IKEA. It's like IKEA, but for a shop. I wonder if that is what Costco is like. There we go. Cornflakes, suitcases. What else we got here? Burgers, more cornflakes. Sausages. Of course, no German shop would be right if it didn't have sausages in it. Okay, so we've got to collect the last of the toilet roll. I think that's it. If I look there's only two things of toilet roll, so we should be good. We're not going to have to keep doing this over and over again like we do with older simulator games. Seriously, those first levels go on for ages. Right, here we go. Pick up the toilet roll. No. Oh, I forgot the keys. There we go. I got it. And off we go. I could have just come straight down here. I didn't need to go and take a scenic tour. But I guess, you know, just have a look at the shop. Seems we only have this set route. I wanted to look down the other end. Seems we don't really get the chance to. Let's cut the corner. Let's take the racing line. Woohoo! Get out of my way, woman. And here we go. Right in the parking lot. Another set of toilet rolls. And down. There we go. Congratulations. You have successfully completed the task. Points for time bonus. 13,000? Nice. Okay. You have unlocked the high bay warehouse section. Okay. Task 2. There are a delivery entrance. New pallets have arrived within the specified time. Bring the respective pallets. Oh, I don't want to do that. I want to go back. I want to go play this new place. Right, here we go. High bay warehouse. Forklift. Ah, here we go. The proper forklifts. This is the stuff. There are in the delivery building pallets that need to be loaded onto the trucks within the specified time. Bring the respective pallets to the locations at the shipping entrance. Try not to damage the goods while driving. Blah, blah, blah. Same as last time. Here we go. Oh, yeah. Okay, right. So we're going... We can't go back. We're going to have to go down this middle bit up here and around. See, this actually looks like the place that is in the original Forklift Truck Simulator. That only had, I believe, one map. I could be wrong, but I think that did only actually have one map. So this is, at least, it's a improvement on the last Forklift Truck Simulator. Right, here we go down here. This is a lot quicker than the old one. This is a pretty nice speed it's going at here. Even if it is controlled by a ghost again. Right, we've got to get this thing up here. So let's get our forklift ready. Oh, here we go. And round. That's nice and lined up, I guess. Here we go. Oh, this is good. This is good. Okay, I'm going to pick that up. And move around. Oh, we're doing a good job here. This is awesome. I wish I could run people over, though. Why do simulator games not let people run them over? It's come on, that's the most fun part. There's more people enjoying the game if you can run people over. It's a fact. Everyone loves Grand Theft Auto because you can run people over. Right, here we go. That was a bit glitchy, but never mind. Through here, onto the truck, and down. Like, come on, down. There we go. And we've got to get another one again. So it's just two packages. A lot easier than I was expecting, actually. Pretty good fun. So one thing I want to mention about this game is there's actually a DLC for it. And if you guys want to see a DLC for this game, what a DLC for a simulator game looks like, to be honest, it actually looks like quite fun, really. I want to go and play it. But let me know if you want to see me play it. It's got zombies in it, which is always fun, really. Right, I can't seem to fit that in that gap. I need to move over a bit more. And round. Oh, 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 oh. There we go. And in. There we go. And down. That's good. We're doing good. Is that everything done? We're going to have to stack more. We need more. Right, here we go. And pick that up. I must have tilted that wrong. Hang on, how can I tilt it back? That's the wrong sort of tilt. Tilt it back. No, I need a bit more. Oh, God. Is this going to fall over? No! Oh my God, look at it! It's just hanging on for dear life! Oh my God! No, no, no! Oh no! Oh no, it just shattered! It shattered. Oh, we messed it up. But it's okay, one just magically appeared right in the same place that we got the other one from. No worries. Right, here we go. Over to the second truck. So I'm guessing it's four pallets for this one. Obviously, it's meant to be a bit harder because it's the second level, of course. Here we go, down here, into the green. We need to kind of straighten up a bit more. Let's get that round like that. That's perfect. Perfect. And down. There we go. Oh, that was it. Just the three. Okay, congratulations. Points for time bonus, 15,000. Pretty good. Okay. There are at the delivery entrance pallets that need to be brought to the building. Within a specified time, bring the respective pallets. Right, here we go. So we need to pick this pallet up without crashing into the wall like I just did. Here we go. That's good. I'm getting the hang of it. I could do this for a job. Yes, we've kind of got it. I think. No. I know, guys, I'm doing a terrible job. Oh, God, I'm not doing a very good job at all, am I? This is awful. I'm doing an awful job. Right, in. Pick it up. Come on now. Can I tilt it the normal way? Why am I doing such a poor job at this? Oh, come on. I've messed it up. Is it going to shatter yet? Oh, come on. I want it to shatter and reset. Oh, screw it. So we can't get to the production facility yet. I'm going to have to go back to the department store because I can't do that at all. Okay, so I'm back in the department store and it's giving me the same freaking task again. Which obviously means now if I go back to the second one, it's going to give me that task again. So I guess, oh, mind you, we're going from a different place this time. So let's mix it up. It's not completely linear. There's a bit of randomness to it. That's cool. That's nice. That's what we like to see. Where we take it? We're taking this to the till this time. We're not actually taking it to the car park. Okay, here we go. That is the car park again. I was wrong. Not the till. That's actually the car park. Move out the way! So, this game, for a tenner, there is not much to do for a game that costs £10. It's currently on offer until March 4th, but the offer is very small. It's still just a bit under £10. Should be just a bit over £10. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and say that there's not much to this game. It's a bit boring. When I say a bit boring, I mean very boring. It's not like, ah, look, they do actually have a bit of variation in the cars. I'll give them that. They've got some very interesting cars. Let's have a look at the cars we've got here. This is a Nissan. Isn't this a Nissan 240Z? It's one of the rare ones. It's a ZX. It's a ZX. 240ZX, 200ZX. Oh God, my classic Nissan knowledge has gone to waste here. A Mercedes. What else we got? This is a Pontiac. I think they actually sold it as another name as well. We'll go over here. So it's a mix of German and American cars here. Chevrolet Blazer. What's this one? A Mitsubishi Mirage, isn't it? Let's move around. It's a Mitsubishi Mirage, I think. We'll go with that. There's a Mark III Volkswagen Golf over there. That's an S10 Chevy Blazer pickup, I think. And obviously the good old Volkswagen Jetta New York taxi cab. It's a Camaro, isn't it? I think it's a Camaro. This is a Peugeot 406, 405. Hello. We're going the same speed as a fat guy walking next to us. We're really slow. But that's nice. There's a bit of variation in the cars. I'll give them that. But that's not worth the almost £10 it costs for this game. Seriously. But you can see they've clearly bought a few more car models. unlike last time. It was, oh God. Absolutely. That New York taxi cab simulator, I've done a video on it. It's terrible. Absolutely terrible. This is terrible, but it's not as terrible. It's okay. Right, there we go. And, oh God, what are we going to do? We're going to pick up more stuff, and I really can't be bothered. That is, what was this game called? Forklift Sunning. It was, it wasn't Taxi. Oh God, what was it called? By the way, there's not a single mention of the name of this game inside the game. I literally, before this video started, I had to remind myself what this game was by minimizing and going to Steam. I think it's called, oh my God, look, there's another van over there. That's a Volkswagen LT transporter van, I think. Well, anyway, that's just a tour of cars in a game that's about picking things up inside of a warehouse. I wouldn't suggest buying it, but there you go, there's a first look. So now you've seen the game, you don't need to buy the game. Well, that's it for this Game Quest video. I'm forgetting every single word in the English dictionary now. I have actually noticed. Is that a weather cycle? That's a weather cycle. It's a very quickly changing weather cycle, but it's a clouds that go over the sun where it dims lights and stuff. It's actually got a bit of, there's a bit of thought that's gone into the atmosphere. So, to be honest, I'll give them that. There's a bit of thought gone into the atmosphere. But apart from gameplay, it's boring. Just, that's it. That is it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. And I will see you next time. Goodbye!